not sure Turkey will be in the top league by mid-December as well. 40% of respondents come from Europe. 60% of respondents are partners in a small and medium practice. 75% of the respondents are male, so we encourage respondents from the female component of the profession. And 70% of the respondents are either sole practitioners or partners in a 2 to 5 partners and staff practice. I also have some, can offer you a sneak peek at the half-time scores of the small and medium practices survey. Again and again, the top three challenges facing SMPs are rising costs, attracting new clients, and keeping up with new technology. And the top issues that will impact the professions over the next 5 years are regulatory environment and the complexity of regulations, competition, which I understand is deeply felt in Turkey as well, and technology developments, the way that IT, information technology, is changing rapidly, is changing the way we do our profession and the way we interact with our clients. So this is one of the most deeply felt topics. Almost 75% of our respondents are telling us that 2014 was the same or was better than 2013. So the climate, the economic climate of the SMEs of the world seems to be improving. And one important thing to consider is also that the majority of our respondents are telling us that in 2015 they expect advisory and consulting and tax to be the fastest growing service. So it's not audit or assurance that it is expected to provide growth in the future, but it's advisory, consulting, and tax consulting. So these might be good ideas for us and for all of you to take home and think and consider. On my final slide, just a few reminders for you. These are the websites that I just mentioned, or the website of the IFAC Small and Medium Practices Committee. I think that these slides will be made available for you, but I do invite you to take a snapshot with your handheld devices of this page. You can also follow us on Twitter at IFAC_SMP. As I told you before, please do join us on the quick poll webpage and take the IFAC SMP survey. You have time until December 15th, but you can take it tonight if you wish in your hotel room. You can also follow us on LinkedIn. We have an IFAC Small and Medium Practices community. It's a virtual community, it's a global community. You're welcome to join. It's on LinkedIn. And we use that community to share our ideas and to get feedback on our future strategy and our future projects. So you can directly input to the strategy and to the work of the IFAC Small and Medium Practices Committee by joining the IFAC LinkedIn community. And also, you see the address of the Global Knowledge Gateway, which I just spoke to you about. So this was the end of my presentation. I would like to thank you for your time, and once again thanks you to the Istanbul Chamber, to Turmo for their support, and thanks to all of you for being with us today. It's been a pleasure for me.
Mr. Attolini, üç önemli ilgili zorluğundan bahsetti bu son araştırmayla ilgili destek mensuplarının. Bir önceki konferansta, bir önceki sempozyumda yine konuşmacıydım galiba. Çok kıdemli bir meslek mensubu yanıma gelip eliyle de şöyle bir işaret yaparak beni birisine benzetmişti sanıyorum. Dedi ki bana, tahsilat nasıl, tahsilat nasıl? Parmaklarıyla şöyle bir para işareti yaptı. Ben bir hafif şok oldum. Acaba ne demek istiyor bu kişi diye. Sonra içeride konuşmaları dinleyince anladım ki bizim meslek mensuplarının en büyük sorunu tahsilat. Bu KGK eğitimlerinde de meslek mensubunun benzer sorunlardan hep bahsettiğine şahit oldum ama en büyük zorluk galiba muhasebeye verilen önem. Yani işletme sahibinin muhasebenin ne kadar önemli olduğunu, işletmeye değer katan bir fonksiyon olduğunu bizim ülkemizde biraz anlamasının zor olmasından kaynaklanıyor diye düşünüyorum. Ama biz bu mesleği nitelikli, sistemli ve disiplinli bir şekilde yapmaya, bunun için de öğrenmeye devam edeceğiz. Şimdi yine bir ikinci tebliğimiz, küçük ve orta ölçekli muhasebecilerin, muhasebecilerde sürdürülebilir başarı için kurumsal yaklaşım ve kalite kontrolü. Sayın Defne Uzun Hasanoğlu, sizi dinliyoruz. Buyurun.